The first addition to my home lab to upgrade my storage situation was the QNAP TS451A NAS. Great little network storage device. Next up though, we have the Noontec TerraMaster D4-310 4-bay enclosure. This thing is, in a way, the opposite concept from the other NAS products I'll be reviewing, and I find that kind of interesting. Let's take a look. I'm EeplesVox, here to make tech easier and more fun today, looking at a new device from TerraMaster and Noontec. This is a DAS, which stands for Desktop Attached Storage, instead of Network Attached Storage of the last review. This is basically a glorified external hard drive enclosure, but it adds a few neat perks. This is a 4-bay unit, but it's actually just two 2-bay units combined. I'll explain why in a moment. On the front, you have LED activity indicators for the four drives, a power LED, and a power button. Next to that are the four drive sleds. They're not toolless, but four easy screws in the bottom of the drives and you're off to the races. The bottom has venting and substantial rubber feet. The sides have a nice aluminum filling with the TerraMaster product logo, which reminds me a little bit of the Cooler Master logo, but whatever. Around back, we have a little more fun. The back houses the two mostly quiet fans. There's also a USB Type-C port for data, DC power input, and two additional USB 3.0 ports for expansion. This is only a USB 3.0 5 gigabit per second capable unit, though they do have a 2-bay that supports USB 3.1. But these two extra ports do mean that you can daisy chain another DAS unit, add flash drives, external hard drives, and so on to expand your storage even more, or just use them as additional USB ports for your computer. In the middle, you have some dials. This selects the storage mode for the two bays inside the device. You have the options of RAID 0 for performance, RAID 1 for redundancy, individual drive access, or JBOD. Use the included tiny flat-headed screwdriver to turn the dial to your desired storage mode and hit the reset button to apply the change, with the unit plugged in and turned on, of course. Keep in mind that changing the storage mode will erase any data on the disks. From there on, the disks show up as normal drives in the disk manager and you need to activate them and format them and so on. It's also worth noting that they actually have the number of the drive bays reversed. So drive bay 2 is at the, or you know, 3 and 4, which is drive bay section 2, is at the top and 1 and 2 are at the bottom. Little weird. This is what I meant by the unit being the opposite of a NAS unit. The Synology and QNAP units I review are special primarily because of the great software they build for them. This unit has no software at all and operates on a hardware level. This can be scary, but makes the process much simpler. This also means that once you activate and format your storage setups, you can plug it into a NAS like the QNAP or Synology that I have and access this over the network too. This will be moved to my server rack soon enough. It's also worth noting that the two sets of hard drives do not interact at all. You cannot create a RAID or JBOD across all four disks, only two at a time. And for whatever reason, they put set 1 below set 2 on the back. So don't reset the wrong set of drives or you might lose some data. And that's it. The unit is simple and fast. They claim up to 410 megabytes per second transfer rates as the maximum for the device with SSDs in there. I haven't quite reached that speed since I'm running mechanical drives, but I was quite impressed with the speeds I did get. I'm quite satisfied with this little thing, though the fans and drive trays are a little louder than my other units. Next time in my storage upgrade progress, we'll be taking a look at my new editing NAS from Synology. Stay tuned.